Alright, we've had balance changes and a bunch of new maps put in the game, so it's time for a new overall Brawler ranking. Let's go over the best and worst Brawlers in Brawl Stars. Alright, so in this overall Brawler ranking, we are including all 5 trophy game modes, not including ticketed game modes. And we're ranking Brawlers 1 to 22 and putting them in tiers A through F. But again, in this overall Brawler ranking, there's going to be no F tier Brawlers. Brawl Stars, I feel like, is a game mode where Brawlers are good in different game modes or in different maps. They're all good, I feel like, in some place, but some are better in more maps and more game modes. Now you're gonna find these rankings are pretty different from last time. Of course there were balance changes, but also another thing that had a really big impact on how good some of these Brawlers are or were is not only were a bunch of maps removed, but there were some maps added too, and this is especially true for Heist and for Bounty. There is a new Brawl Ball map though as well. And more importantly for Brawl Ball, the goals got pushed back, which completely changed the mode. All right, let's start out at the bottom of the ranking at number 22 and in the D tier. These are Brawlers that are not that versatile usually. They might excel in something, but not in that much. A lot of times they're either really good at one or max 2 specific things, but usually they're like just okay at a lot. 22, it's gonna be Crow. Crow is pretty good in Heist, but actually a lot of these new Heist maps are not that great for Crow, especially compared to some of the ones that were removed. Crow is better on those maps than he is going to be on some of these new ones, which really favor a lot of long-range, high-damage Brawlers, as opposed to control orientation that Crow can be really good at. Crow is okay in Showdown, but otherwise Crow isn't used that much, and he tends to get outplayed fairly easily with not dealing that much damage and having a really low amount of health. At 21 and in the D tier, it's going to be Colt. Colt is honestly a Brawler that's really versatile, but he's also not that great at much. He's really high skill cap, so if you are amazing with Colt, you can be the exception. You can play him in a lot of different game modes, but he's not going to be that great anywhere. He's not going to be one of the worst Brawlers, and he's definitely not going to be one of the best Brawlers either, though. So it tends to be sort of his weakness. He's not very good on walls, or sorry, on maps with a lot of walls that get in his way. He doesn't shoot around corners like any other Brawlers. He's a very straightforward Brawler. He can deal a lot of damage in bursts, but it's definitely in bursts. He's not going to be dealing it that much that often. It's going to come and go a lot. He's an inconsistent Brawler. But if you're hitting your shots with Colt, he can be really good. He just also tends to be really inconsistent. At 20 and in the D tier, it's going to be Frank. Frank is pretty good in Brawl Ball, and he's all right in Jump Grab, but he's also a really matchup-dependent Brawler. He's definitely matters a lot what Brawlers he's matching up against, and some of the Brawlers that got buffed do not really help out Frank. Like a Daryl buff definitely doesn't help out Frank. Daryl can deal with Frank pretty easily, and you're going to see Daryl pretty high in this ranking. So Frank is not used in a lot of different game modes. That's definitely part of his weakness. He, of course, is a very map-specific Brawler with an attack where he actually literally stops moving. So he's definitely map-specific. And Frank can put out a good amount of pressure when he has his super, but he also tends to feed the enemy team their supers a lot really easily, as, of course, he just stands there when he attacks and he has a ton of health. So Frank, he has the situations where he can be really useful and he can make really flashy plays with that super, but otherwise, he tends to not be quite as great. At 19 and the last in the D tier, it's gonna be Piper. Piper is one of the best Brawlers in Bounty, but everywhere else, she's basically okay at best. Doesn't hit all her shots that often, and with a really slow reload, she's also a bit of a high skill cap Brawler and also very map specific. Not very good in this meta either with some of these really high health Brawlers going around. Piper, you prefer to have a low health meta for Piper because she does such a high amount of damage, but in a really a small amount of burst. It's hard for Piper to hit more than 2 shots in a row. You can get those 2 shots in a row, not easily, but you can definitely make it happen. Any more than that, and you tend to be asking for a lot, especially asking someone to do that on a consistent basis. All right, now we're into the C tier, and these Brawlers definitely have their weaknesses. They might be good at more than one game mode, but they're probably not excelling at multiple. At 18, it's gonna be Shelly. Shelly is definitely solid in Brawl Ball, where she can break down walls, has a really good defensive super, and can deal with a lot of the tanks that you might see in Brawl Ball. But that's the thing with Shelly, is she's a tank counter. So you're going to play her on any sort of game mode or map where tanks are going to be really prevalent, where you're going to see a lot of tanks. But otherwise, you're really not going to want to play Shelly, as you get anything in a game mode where there's not a tank, and you're probably going to regret having Shelly, honestly. She is a tank counter, and when there aren't tanks on the map, she really struggles, as she doesn't do much chip damage, and her super is not very good at chip damage either. At 17, it's going to be Dynamike. Now, Dynamike is definitely good in Heist, and he's definitely good in Showdown, but otherwise he can be pretty to really map specific, as he doesn't have quite as much control as some other brawlers do. He can deal a lot of damage, but he doesn't always get that consistent amount of hits with Dynamike. He's a bit of a high skill cap brawler, especially with his jump, so he's really solid in Heist, but he's also pretty map specific, and especially with all these high health brawlers going around, as I was saying earlier, it's hard for Dynamike to get that consistent amount of damage, consistent amount of hits, and some of these brawlers have faster move speeds too, which is definitely not good for Dynamike. You got a Mortis buff, you got a Daryl buff, those are two bad things for Dynamike, so he's gonna be a little bit lower on the rank. At 16, and in the C tier, it's gonna be Bull. Now, Bull is one of the better brawlers in Heist, but actually, some of these new maps are not quite as good for Bull as some of the old ones. On top of that, one of his competition, Daryl, got a really good buff. So now Bull is a little bit more replaceable than he used to be in Heist, where he was clearly the best tank. Now that's definitely up for grabs, and Daryl's probably taking that position as the best tank in Heist on some of those maps. Now, Bull can be used in a couple other places. Like, he can be not bad in Showdown. He can be not bad in Gem Grab. But honestly, Bull, look, he's a lot better at lower trophies than he's gonna be at higher trophies. As you get higher in trophies, you're gonna find people are much more adept at keeping their distance and being much more smart situationally versus tanks and other close range brawlers. So if you're at lower trophies and you're wondering, why is Shelly so low? I get destroyed by Shellys in the bush so often. Probably because you're not checking bushes as well, and you're not keeping your distance as well as some of these higher trophy players who are more experienced with the game are going to be doing. That's also true for Bull and another tank like El Primo and just other tanks and close range brawlers in general. So Bull, he has some uses, but it's not going to be that many. Now at 15, it's going to be El Primo. Now I think El Primo is slightly more versatile than Bull, but it's not by that much. He's definitely good in Brawl Ball. He's one of the better gem carriers, really good offensive force. He's usable in Gem Grab, and he's usable in Heist, but there's definitely better options. So, I mean, El Primo's similar to Bull. As you get higher in trophies, he's not going to be quite as good. Now, at 14, and the last in the C tier, it's going to be Bow. Now, Bow got some really big changes with his star power going from a 6-tile vision in the bush to now being 4 tiles in the bush. On top of that, his damage got about a 15% damage increase, which is a lot. So he really got a huge rework. And honestly, what this ended up happening is overall, Bo probably got more versatile. He's able to be used on more maps, but on top of that, you sort of have to learn how to play Bo differently. The teams you're gonna be playing with Bo in the maps you're using him on has now changed, because before you'd be playing him on these maps that are super grassy, and he was one of the best brawlers there, no question. Now it's not quite the same. He's now basically no longer one of the best brawlers on those maps. He's still a solid option. And on the other maps, he went from maybe being not an option to being somewhat of an option. All right, now we're into the B tier. These brawlers are not quite as map specific, not quite as game mode specific, but they do still have some weaknesses. So you gotta keep that in mind. At number 13, it's gonna be Penny. Now, Penny is actually one of the best brawlers in Bounty. I mean, combined with her cannon, her turret is so, so good in Bounty, really long range, makes a lot of sense. She's also a really solid pick in Gem Grab. She's not gonna be like one of the best gem carriers, but she's a really solid choice, and her cannon is still really hard to deal with. And there's actually a lot of good maps for Penny in Gem Grab. She's also usable as a sort of control brawler with that cannon in a couple different other places, either in Brawl Ball or oddly sometimes in Heist as well, as that cannon can play a really big part in doing really well in those situations, although you do tend to rely on your teammates and you need a pretty good team comp for that as well. Now at 12, it's actually gonna be Poco. Now Poco only got a small buff to his star power going from 400 healing to 500 every time he heals a teammate. But honestly, one of the biggest differences for Poco is the meta. Poco is really good in a high health meta where he has teammates that are in front of him where he can use his star power on them and hit and attack the enemy. And as well as that, if he has people on his team who are all going in on the enemy, not only does it tend to cause the enemy to group up, allowing Poco to get more hits, but he can use his star power even more effectively, hitting multiple teammates at the same time. So, I mean, buffs like to Daryl and to Mortis, and even that buff to Nita were all really good for Poco. So Poco can be really solid in Gem Grab, usable in Brawl Ball, in Duo Showdown. I mean, Poco with this meta, it's a really good meta for Poco. If some of those Brawlers get nerfed, I would expect Poco to slide down just because of that. Now at 11, it's going to be Jessie. Jessie is a really good control Brawler. She can get a lot of bounce shots, especially at lower trophy ranges where people are not as good at avoiding those bounce shots. Jessie could be even a little bit higher on this list because of that, but she's a really solid pick in Gem Grab. She's really good in Brawl Ball as well, and surprisingly, you can even use her a little bit in Heist 2 because she's such a good control option. You can use her turret in a variety of different ways, but Jessie is still a really solid pick, can hit multiple people fairly easily. She does have a bit of low health, so that is definitely one of her weaknesses, and if she doesn't have her turret, if her team doesn't have control and you're throwing down her turret, you're going to lose it pretty fast. So there are situations where Jessie is not quite as useful, but otherwise, she can be a pretty solid Brawler to play. At number 10, and the last in the B tier, it's actually going to be Rico. Now, Rico honestly only got kind of a small buff, like a 7% damage buff. But Rico is one of those Brawlers that's really hard to match up against. There's not many Brawlers who can take Rico on and straight up win that fight the majority of the time. Rico has such a high damage, but that ability with a long range to bounce off the wall, he can hit people so many times where they can't hit him. And that small buff was enough to make him win a lot of those matchups, just enough to keep him going. But he's pretty good in Jump Grab. He's pretty good in Brawl Ball, because look, Brawl Ball has even more walls now in Brawl Ball, actually. So he got a solid indirect buff in Brawl Ball. You can use him on some of these heist maps as well. Some of these heist maps are also pretty good for Rico with some of these new walls that allow him to be pretty viable there. He's also decent in Bounty as well and in Showdown. So Rico, you can play him in a lot of different modes. He's really solid. All right, now into the A tier, and these Brawlers are viable in a lot of different places, but not quite everywhere. They definitely have some weaknesses, but they're really solid. At number 9, it's going to be Barley. Barley got a solid buff in the last update, or last balance change. Now, he also got a bit of a nerf to his super with, in Heist, it no longer stacks damage on top of the safe, on the safe, or in one direct play. So definitely a bit of a nerf in Heist, but he got a star power buff and a damage buff, and those were really solid buffs. So overall, can't just look at him in the chasm of one game mode. Overall, he got a solid buff. So Barley is a really viable, really versatile Brawler right now, good in Jump Grab. Good in Heist, still really good in Heist. He's a really good control Brawler. He's honestly one of the best control Brawlers in the game. He's not going to do a lot of damage very fast, but he's going to keep you where you are and allow your team to get control of the map, which is definitely one of the most underrated things in Brawl Stars. So Barley is really good at that. At number 8, it's going to be Tara. Now, Tara can be a slow starting Brawler. If you have a bad start with Tara, you might not have a good game because it can take a while to charge up her super in the beginning. But if once you get her super, you can start chaining that super and you can have a huge impact throughout the course of a game. I mean, Tara, because of stuff like that, can be really good in Gem Grab, going for objective kills on a certain person or just getting any sort of kills. Always useful to get control of the map. Same in Brawl Ball, Tara can put out a ton of pressure in all these game modes where people tend to group up because they have to go for some objective. Tara can be really, really solid, getting multiple kills, putting out a lot of pressure, and also just a really big threat that people have to respect and keep their distance from, which can also be really good by itself. At number 7, it's going to be Brock. Now, I don't think Brock is overpowered in any sort of sense, but he's also really solid in a lot of different things. He's good at Jump Grab, really good in Heist, really good in Brownie. He's kind of usable in Brawl Ball, and he's pretty good in Solo Showdown and Duo Showdown. He's one of the best Brawlers at getting kills. He's a really good long-range Brawler. He's really hard to deal with because he has such a long range. It's very hard to approach him, and he has solid damage just with one hit. And if you add in his star power, which did get a buff, he's even better. Of course, his super is a little inconsistent, but it can go over walls, can break down walls, which is a really good, useful super, allowing him to be used in a lot of different game modes for a lot of different purposes. All right, at number 6, it's going to be Mortis. Now, Mortis got a pretty solid buff. 12.5% damage buff. On top of that, I actually think he got a buff to his star power as well. It's a bit of a nerf, but I think it's more of a buff. Instead of leaving those green skulls, he now gets healed 1,800 health from 1,000. So a definite good increase to the amount of health he gets healed. This is a ton of health to be healed for one kill. It allows him to be a lot more aggressive, because if he does get that kill, he gets a huge heal afterwards. So Mortis, especially in this meta, can be really, really solid. And that damage buff, I mean, honestly, part of the thing with Mortis too is he's really versatile. He can be used in a lot of different gameplays. He's a bit map specific, a little bit matchup dependent. You do want to stay away from certain brawlers, but with that really fast move speed and an attack that allows him to move around really fast, he can avoid the bad matchups and just go straight for the good matchups, which is definitely basically one of the only reasons he's up here, because he can just go straight for that matchup. But you can use him in Gem Grab really well. You can use him in Brawl Ball still, even though he got nerfed. He's not going to be as good as he was with the change to Brawl Ball, but he's still a really, he's a solid brawler there. And you can still use him really well in Showdown, and you can use him really well in Bounty. He matches up well versus a lot of those brawlers in Bounty. So Mortis is going to be a really solid brawler compared to what he used to be. And now at number five, it's going to be Nita. Nita is a really solid brawler, and she actually got a star power buff as well. She can be used in a lot of different game modes, and actually she's really easy to use. She's got a ton of health, super fast reload speed, can use walls really well to use, get really good chip shots, and that bear is really good in objective-based modes, allowing you to push the enemy team back, force them to shoot something else, and it follows them, so she can be really useful in a lot of different ways. Nita is a very solid brawler right now. At number four, and the last in the A tier, it's actually going to be Leon. Now, Leon did get a nerf last balance changes. He's no longer quite the same overpowered brawler that he used to be. He got a damage nerf, and he got a nerf to his star power, or not his star power, his super, making it last from 10 seconds down to 8 seconds. But if you're looking for a brawler who's going to be one of the best individual killers in the game, it's still going to be Leon. He's not quite as overpowered as he used to be. You can counter him a little bit better with a little bit less damage, and his super not lasting quite as long, not being quite as useful. He's still gonna be good in Jump Grab, still gonna be good in Bounty, still gonna be good in Brawl Ball. Now in the S tier brawlers, top three, these brawlers are arguably overpowered, good at basically every game, but maybe not every single map, but they're really good overall and good in a lot of different places. At number three, it's gonna be the Trash Can Daryl. But is he really a trash can? Because Daryl is so strong right now. He got a huge buff with his star power, damage reduction going from 30% to 40%, and he got an 8% damage buff. Daryl is really solid, but he's also really, really versatile. He's a borderline top five brawler in every single game mode. He's just so hard to deal with. And similar to how Mortis can just go for the matchups he wants because he's such a really good movement speed and positioning brawler, Daryl is really similar as well, if not even better, because he can do it even more suddenly, making it even harder for the enemy team to react to you and the Daryl going in and rolling in. On top of that, there's a lot of new maps with water, which is a really good thing for Daryl, because he can roll over water and extend his rolls, allowing you to have an even longer roll, which in a super that he gets so often can be really, really useful. At number two, it's going to be Pam. Now, Pam didn't get any buff or nerf last update, but she was already really strong. Pam is going to be one of the best control options in the game. A really wide and continuous healing that can just allow you and your teammates to keep on putting pressure out. On top of that, as a control brawler, she's one of the few that can hold her own without her super, without anything else, because she does a ton of damage potentially, especially at close range, and she has a really high amount of health. So Pam can be really difficult to deal with. She can win a lot of matchups, but most importantly, she's one of the best control brawlers in the game. All right, at number one, the best brawler in Brawl Stars right now, it's gonna be Spike. I mean, look, Spike, he's not really overpowered, but he's the most versatile brawler in the game, and it's really not even close. He has a really long range. He has a ton of damage potentially if you get a direct hit. He has a super that can go over walls. He has a super that has area of control. Also, it slows people down. Also, it heals himself a ton of health, which is really useful. Oh, and did I mention that Spike can also attack around walls? So he has all these attributes that make him really, really versatile. He can be used in basically every single map, in basically every single game mode you can play Spike, and he's a really solid brawler. He's not gonna be the best brawler in probably any of those modes, but he is usable and really good in all of them. Wanna see the best brawlers for specific game modes? Check out that playlist right over there telling you exactly that. It's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you later.